respected honorable speaker sir, thank you so much for allowing me to speak on today's topic, women empowerment. I would like to start by congratulating the leader of the house, our honorable chief minister YS Jagan Mohan Reddy garu, for the emphatic win registered in municipal polls, and also thanking him for giving due representation to women in all spheres of governance. Honorable speaker sir, Savitri Bai Phule garu in the 19th century had given the war cry to all the women, stating, "Awake, arise, educate, smash traditions and liberate." But sir, unfortunately, even today in the 21st century, we see women under respected in all spheres of life. But I would also like to reiterate that our honorable CM garu has given true meaning to the call and has done all that it needs to ensure that women get what they deserve, and that it is evidence that his actions also like to reiterate that to ensure women what they deserve. Today I'm standing in front of you to put forth my opinion that all his actions are a living testimony. I repeat again sir, all these actions are a living testimony for giving due representation to women in the state. Sir, it is a fact that when given an opportunity to women have not left any stone unturned to prove their capability. If you look around, we can get numerous examples to substantiate there is a fact. And the recently concluded Tokyo Olympics and Paralympics are a classic example about how women have brought the glory to the nation when given an opportunity to one of them being the one from our Telugu land named PV Sindhu. Sir, on behalf of all the women, I thank our honorable CM garu for reposing faith in Nari Shakti and giving us the opportunity to prove ourselves. I would just like to highlight some of the data points from recently concluded local body polls. Sir, out of the 635 ISRCP MPPs, a whooping 64% are women candidates. Out of 13 YSRCP ZP chairmen, 54% are women. Out of the 12 corporation mayors, again, 67% of them are women. Out of 74 municipality chairmen, again, 59% of them are women. Out of 135 nominated corporation chairmen, around 50% of them are women. Besides all this due representation given to women, majority of the schemes introduced by the Honorable CM garu are women-centric. A scheme named YSR Cheyuta, the brainchild of Honorable CM garu, is a perfect life example of women empowerment. A welfare-oriented scheme focusing on building economic sustainability. Around 24 lakh SC, ST, BC minority women have been benefited through this scheme. It has empowered them by guiding into entrepreneurship and helping them to establish a strong business, creating their own employment opportunities and to be financially stable by themselves. Also, to elevate women out of debt trap and financial burden, our Honorable CM sir introduced schemes like YSR Asara and Sunavaddi. In the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals 2030, gender equality and women empowerment is one of the most important agenda. I feel proud to say that compared to any state or any country, we are far way ahead in reaching towards the gender equality through the schemes and initiatives taken by Jagananna government, sir. Besides schemes and initiatives, our Honorable CM also gives us utmost importance to women's safety in our state. Disha application introduced by the Honorable CM Garu is a true blessing for women and girls in distress and who are facing many problems. Several times it provided to be a great source of help and safety for women and girls in the state. There are several cases as thousands of women and girls got the app downloaded and received many times help from this police within no time. Speaker sir, I cannot recollect that there has been any government in the past that has been so much considerate about giving women what they deserve and what we need. So now I proudly say that on behalf of all the women of our state to our Honorable CM that we wholeheartedly thank our Honorable CM YS Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu for this embarking this noble tradition. Sir, there is a saying in Sanskrit, Yatra Naryastu Pujyante Ramante Tatra Devata, Yatre Tastu Na Pujyante Sarvastatra Phala Kriyaha, which translates, where women are honored, divinity blossoms there. And when they are dishonored, all actions remain unfruitful. Which means, I'm sure, sir, all these attempts and initiatives taken by our Honorable CM YS Jagan Mohan Reddy Garu will definitely lead to positive results for all of us and also especially to the state. Here, sir, I would like to end saying that there was an experience by me with our leader, sir. I was going through a hurdle. So the time I met our leader, the leader gives me strength, stating that, like a father, like a brother, you are like my sister. Trust me, I am with you. Be confident. I repeat, sir, our leader gave me strength, saying that, like a father, like a brother, you are like my sister. Trust me, I am with you. Be confident. This is a confident not only a woman representative like me got from a leader, sir. Today, every woman in the state feels the same. And I, with your permission in the house, this message I want to reach to the entire woman in the state, sir. That is the reason I took an opportunity to repeat what happened. So this gives us strength and support, sir. And I wish every woman feels very bold in the state. And I hope our leader, whom we call as the brother of the state, who is the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh, our Jagan Anna, is a brother for all the women of the state. And I thank the leader of the house and also Speaker sir, thank you for giving this opportunity. Thank you, sir.